Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Everyone's doing well. Anyway, so today was Movie Tuesday, guys, and picked up some awesome movies at Best Buy, and picked up some movies off Amazon as well for the past like week. And I picked up a movie yesterday from Walmart, so I'm going to show you what we got today first, or maybe the Amazon first, and Stinky Tuna as well. Forgot Stinky Tuna.
No, I wanted to say this real quick because when we were going to Best Buy today, I was telling Kimberly that I was going for the Total Recall 4K Steelbook, and I was also going for the Blade 4K Steelbook, just as a collectibles. And I told her in the car that if they didn't have those, that I told Kimberly that I didn't know if I was going to go back or not.
Yeah.
Because
it's been pretty bad.
We're not doing so hot when it comes to collecting some of these movies. But so anyway, they had the 4K Blade Steelbook,
which came out last week. I'm surprised they still had one.
But here's the thing: they didn't have the Total Recall. They had just a regular 4K, but they didn't have the Steelbook, and we didn't see anywhere.
Yeah.
Where a label was, you know, designated for the 4K Steelbook, and so I didn't bother asking. So anyway, when we got home today, I said, just out of curiosity, let me go to Best Buy's site, and sure enough, they had them showing that they were available in the store.
Yeah.
So apparently they hadn't put them out, which is kind of weird, but it's kind of getting like that. So UPS truck. So anyway, the point is, if I had to ask, I probably wouldn't be able to purchase one from there. But for some reason, again, they didn't put them out, and I don't understand with it being a release date, that why wouldn't they put it out on a release date? And they're kind of getting like that. And last week, real quick, I was looking for the
Blade when it came out.
No. Well, I was looking for that one too, but I was looking for the Hobbit.
Oh yeah,
the 4K Steelbook set, and I was also looking for the what's the other one?
Lord of the Rings
4K Steelbook, and there was nothing. I think we mention that before.
Yeah, they didn't.
I don't think we mentioned that, but they didn't have anything out.
Yeah,
and I had already told Kimberly because I wanted those sets. You know, I could have pre-ordered them.
Yeah.
The only problem with pre-ordering Steelbooks is
you just don't know.
You don't know. You take a chance. So I'd rather be able to have. You know, it should be in the store. Or being in the store, at least I have a chance where I can look at it and see if there's any damage, whatever. But what I don't understand about Best Buy, real quick, is why don't they allocate? Which, by the way, they used to do this before this coronavirus, I guess, because some people say that it's partly due to the coronavirus, or it's either because they're trying to get away from the physical media, which is very possible. I was talking to a customer today.
Yeah, no.
He and I were talking about that. He believes it's the same thing, that they're trying to move away from that.
Yeah.
But the point is, not to, because I'm kind of dragging this out again, is if it's a release date for a movie, why doesn't Best Buy allocate some for the customers to come in there?
Right.
Because, you know, not everybody wants to have to order these, you know, pre-order these. Because really, truthfully, we never had to do that before.
Yeah.
So,
but
anyway, I mean, I kind of dragged it out, but I just don't understand with Total Recall 4K Steelbook. And it's really no big deal because the 4K Steelbook looks basically just like the Blue that was released
in the UK
some years ago. No. No, the UK has a 4K as well. Oh, was that just a UK release, the
that
Blue?
That was a UK Blu-ray.
Okay, so basically it's the same.
Yeah.
But I just wanted it for my collection, so. Anyway, like I said earlier, I kind of went.
But you did order one.
Didn't I kind of go around the barn door?
No, but he did
to
order
get to
one.
The, no, I walked around the barn to get to the front door.
But he did
something
order
like
one from Best Buy to be shipped here. He was going to pick it up at the store, but there was no in-store available. It was just curbside, which makes no sense. It's at the store anyway. Why can't you have it in store instead of just curbside? I don't understand that. But anyway,
but the point is that I'm really beginning to get away from it, and I'm probably just going to do more, like I said before, do the Amazon thing.
Yep.
And of course, and do some of the other specialty stores that are online, like with some of them, like Vinegar Syndrome.
Yep. Stinky Tuna's has some good ones.
Stinky Tuna's another one. And, you know, people don't like that because they figure that's a
bootleg, but it works. Bootleg. But anyway.
Hey, whatever.
I'm going to show you what he got off Stinky Tuna first, and then I'll show you the two Amazon ones. And then I'll show you the one I got at Walmart yesterday. We'll do the Best Buy ones today, okay? All right, so the one from Stinky Tuna. This does not have a Blu-ray release, which I don't understand. In the U.S., I think Germany has one, if I'm not mistaken. Mm-hmm. No,
I've never seen one in Germany.
Sure? I heard someone say that they had one over there. It was in German or something. I don't remember. But anyway, that is Fire in the Sky. This, like I said, this is from Stinky Tuna. Haven't seen this one yet. He said this is actually really, really good.
It's a very good movie, and I think everybody knows it's about the story that I mentioned last time about Travis Walton. You know, everybody think no. I think if anybody, I don't know. That's probably a movie that a lot of people more than likely didn't hear of. But anyway, it's a group of lumberjacks, and it's late in the evening, and they see this light in the sky, so they're all curious, so they go to it. And what ends up happening is the Travis Walton character decides to basically walk up under the light. And of course he gets
abducted,
right. He gets pulled up into the light. And what happens is the story basically from there just goes that nobody believes what the other four guys, I think it was four guys, lumberjacks, were saying about what had happened. And there's actually I think in an investigation, if I remember, that starts up, and I think that's played by James Garner, because he doesn't believe their story as well. But anyway, long story short, he ends up, I think it's 5 days after he's abducted, and then what he does, he recounts of what had happened, supposedly happened. And like I had mentioned before in the previous video, he did appear, the actual Travis Walton had appeared on Oprah Winfrey.
Yeah.
And it was kind of interesting. I mean, this kind of dates back, but I think, and like I said before, I want to say that he failed the polygraph test.
Yeah.
So I don't know if that necessarily means anything, but the bottom line is, it's still a very good movie, regardless, even if it's based on a lie or a story that's made up. But it's still very good. And the fact is that you can get that in a blue. And of course, I already had bought some blues from Stinky Tuna, and I'm very impressed with them.
Yep.
I think it was True Lies. I think one of the first ones, The Beastmaster. We bought the.
We didn't get The Beastmaster from
Stinky Tuna. Oh, I didn't get The Beastmaster.
You got Twilight.
The Twilight Zone, the movie.
The
no, it was Twilight Zone,
right.
The movie.
Yeah.
I got that, and I haven't opened it. And I mentioned before I have two of the original. But the fact is, to have that in blue, and I don't understand. And just like Emily had mentioned earlier. We don't understand, and we've questioned this many times. The movie came out, I think, like in 94. So why the hell hasn't it been released here in the States? I mean, what's the deal? Is it something political? Is it because who put that movie out? What company did? It says it on there. This is Paramount. Paramount.
Yeah.
So once again, we have to wait. That movie could eventually come out, but we just don't. So what? That's 26 years.
Yeah.
So 26
crazy.
Years. And you know, like I said before, some of these movies in blue, hey, they may or may not ever be released again.
Yeah.
We don't, is it May?
May.
Yeah.
You're right.
They may not be released again, you know, from a DVD format or from whatever. So to have it in blue and be able to watch it, it looks really, really good.
Yeah.
I mean, True Lies
looks amazing.
Looked really, really good. The best,
yes.
You know, like everybody else says, the best I've ever seen it.
Yeah. All right, so the next one up, the next two are from Amazon, guys. Now, this is from Kino Lorber, which is really cool. I didn't know that until he got it. And it's got, what's his name, Mr. T?
Mr.
T. Mm-hmm. And it's called DC Cab from Kino Lorber, like I said. But from, 1983? Yeah. So, if you want to read about it here, guys.
Yeah, and I really don't know much about that movie.
Yeah.
It's probably one of those movies that kind of mixes in with all the other movies that I remember seeing back in the 80s and 90s. Of course, that's the 80s.
Yeah.
So I don't really remember that one. Definitely have to watch it to see if it's good or not. But I thought it was unique because that I don't think you mentioned it the first time.
First time
in being in blue. Yeah, it's the first time that's in blue.
Joel Schumacher. Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Didn't he do that falling down?
Falling
down too with Michael Douglas?
Yes. Awesome movie.
Very good movie.
All right, so the
and this is another one. This is another one I thought was pretty cool, too. The first time I think that's been released on Blu-ray.
All right, so the final one from Amazon, guys, and then we'll get to the Blu-ray one, or the Best Buy ones. this is from Screen Factory, which I didn't know that until he got it, but a movie called The Car with James Brolin and Ronnie Cox. But it says, is a phantom, a demon, or the devil himself? So I love the art on this one. I've never even seen this movie before or even heard of it, but... want to read about here, guys?
Yeah, and I wanted to mention something real quick that's a little bit off topic. Well, it's not off topic necessarily, but, you know, we've been talking about having a different background because we keep mentioning it. We haven't had a chance to do this yet, you know, especially with Christmas, but I was telling Kimberly that eventually, probably by the end of this year or the beginning of next year, we'll definitely have a different background. Maybe have something more movie-themed than having a good old... You know, the refrigerator that I hit. You know, I'm surprised no one ever mentioned anything about that when I said I hit it with my car. I thought that was kind of cool, but apparently they didn't.
All right, so the one I got yesterday from Walmart, I can't think it came out
last
week.
Wait, do the rest of mine.
Oh, well, do you mind? We get to that?
No. Finish it. Please. We're gonna get into it.
I'm going to do that in a minute. I'm going to do this one first. I said that.
I said always go through mine and get mine
all
through.
All right.
And then go to yours. Do yours last.
All right.
You think that's better?
All right. So... Now, this one, this came out a couple months ago, but this is the only way you can get this movie in 4K, was a Steelbook edition, and that's what's called The Tax Collector, with Bobby Soto and Shia LaBeouf. I love the art of this one. Like I said, this is the only way you get it in 4K is with the Steelbook. You can't get a slipcover edition, which I don't understand, but...
I think I've seen that in blue.
Yeah, you can get it in Walmart. Blue as well, yeah.
And did you hear what I was saying to the customer? Talking to. I said, you know, like I always have to kind of repeat myself that I bought that as a collectible. I didn't buy it to open.
Yeah.
But what I'll do is, more likely, since I have it in my collection, I'll buy it in blue and watch it. It's, you know, I think you can get it in blue for is it about $17?
I think so. I'm not sure, but
I can't remember.
This
either.
Is a cool looking Steelbook.
Oh, and by the way, one thing to mention too, because I always mention price, because I know people get pissed off at me saying that. That movie there was $13. Yeah. That 4K was $12.99.
Awesome.
I thought that was really good, especially for a 4K. Yeah. Now, I don't know if the movie's any good, but you know, we shall see.
I think Chatty Bobby said it was actually pretty good. So I was watching his channel or video the other day. He was talking about how he got that. So anyway, so the final one.
In 4K?
Yeah, because that's the only way you can get it is in 4K.
Steelbook.
That's the only way you can get that movie in 4K is a Steelbook. You can't get it any other way.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. So, but we can buy it in blue.
Yes. But if you want the 4K, you have to get the Steelbook because you can't get it any other way. All right. So, the final
it's
one.
Cold.
I'm so freaking excited he picked this up. This came out last week. We didn't pick it up last week because they didn't have any in the store when we went there. But they had one left at our Best Buy today. And that is Blade. This is the 4K Steelbook. I love this movie so much. We watched it for the first time, or, you know, the 31 Nights of Halloween. Freaking love this movie so much. So fun. I mean, Wesley Snipes as Blade was awesome, guys. But, what?
Let me see something.
What you looking at?
I just wanted to say something about the 4K Steelbook. It was Warner Brothers that released it.
Oh, okay.
And I think, if I remember correctly, the other two were released by... Well, I could be wrong. I'm just kind of guessing. But my guess is they probably were released by Warner Brothers. So what I don't understand, and here we go again with this, is if they were all released by Warner Brothers and they could release this one in 4K, why didn't they release a trilogy? But why don't... There's a blue... You can buy the blue trilogy.
Right.
So why is it they couldn't... That this one couldn't be made in a 4K trilogy? And, you know, then that's one thing I'm really getting kind of tired of. I'm getting kind of tired about, listen, let me hold this. If I bind this one in 4K, the other two I have in blue.
Right.
So I don't have a complete, this is not a complete set. This is just one in 4K.
Right.
And somebody, the customer I was talking to at Best Buy today, he said what they'll probably do is bleed them out.
Right.
Bleed them out like they always do. They'll come out with a second.
And
then eventually they'll come out with a third.
And then
what they'll do, they'll come out with a trilogy set.
A Steelbook set, probably.
And here, well, a trilogy set.
Oh, yeah.
Or it could be just one with the three.
Exactly.
You know, one and three, like the trilogy. Well, they call it a trilogy.
Yeah.
Or they could have three individual ones.
Right.
But that's what I'm kind of getting away from. I just wanted this one because I thought it was pretty cool.
I love
once again
movie.
To have in my
so
collection
good.
Is because I've already seen the movie. And by the way, I don't need to see it in 4K.
I'll buy it from you.
Wait a second. I don't need to see it in 4K. And I know a lot of you guys probably get tired of me saying the same thing over and over. With the 4K and the blue, a customer that I was talking to today at Best Buy, he agrees with me. And a lot of people have agreed with me talking about the 4K and the blue, that they're not seeing the difference they maybe saw before. Not that necessarily there was a...
Yeah.
What's a word? A major difference?
Right.
Or what would you call it? That there was really a big difference between the blue. I mean...
There wasn't enough of...
I don't know. How do you say? The color, the contrast, right. The bright, the light, whatever. That there wasn't a lot of difference. And they actually agree with me. He agreed with me. And he said that he finds himself, too, buying more of the blue than he does a 4K. And I've said this before, and he agreed with me as well. He said because he had upgraded his TV. The TV, folks, makes a huge difference.
Yep.
Regardless of how much this crap, I don't call it crap, but how much these information's out here on social media or on YouTube about numbers. I've always said before, the only thing I need to do is watch it, and then I can determine the difference.
Yeah.
Or if there is a difference. And I was going to say something real quick. And I was telling the customer about the DVDs. Even the DVDs look exceptionally good. If not, you can make an argument. Because we always get into what does a 4K look like? What does a blue look like? But we're talking about, you know, if it's a good color, if the characters are detailed, if the backing is detailed, the colors are bright, you know, that kind of thing. Wait a minute. Wait a second. That's what our TV does.
Yeah.
So it makes a big difference. And I know you guys get tired of me saying that, but I really believe that.
Yeah, because we watched this in blue, and it was it was phenomenal in Blu-ray. So we watched all the first two in Blu-ray, and it was phenomenal. So
well, anything that we put into this new TV
looks amazing.
It looks amazing. I mean, the only one that didn't look as good I had a little issue with was the Home Alone that we watched last night, the very first one.
Yeah.
I noticed that the actors, they didn't look as detailed. They almost had like a bland, just a bland of words.
The second one looks amazing.
Yeah, the second one is
phenomenal.
For some reason or another is much
so much
better. And you know, it could have to do because of the colors.
Yeah.
Maybe because it's
awesome.
A lot of it is shot in dark, isn't it?
A lot of it
isn't
is.
A lot
yes.
of it shot in dark from
yes.
I remember compared to the first one.
Yes.
So anyway, that's pretty much all I have to say. I mean, I know people get tired of me saying that. Do you agree?
Yes, I agree.
Do you agree with me?
Yes. All right, so let's want to show you what I picked up. I'm going to show you what I picked up at Walmart yesterday, guys.
I'll give you the money. I'll give you that money, the $20 later for agreeing with me.
Oh, anyway. So this came out last week, and...
It's cold on this floor.
Sure.
It's cold. Did I tell?
Yes, you did. Anyway, so I was at Walmart yesterday, and I saw this one. It was $10. I've never seen this movie, but he said it's not really that good. But I've been wanting to see it, and I'll determine if it's really good or not. But and that is a movie called Popeye. This is the 40th anniversary edition. First time to Blu-ray, and I like the cover of this one. It's pretty cool. But it's got Robin Williams, of course, is playing Popeye, and Shirley Duvall as Olive Oil. So I'll be watching this one tonight, guys, after we watch our Christmas movie. And I'll determine if I like it or not. But like I said, it was only $10 at Walmart.
That movie came out in the 80s sometime.
1980.
Oh, 1980?
This is the 40th anniversary edition.
I don't think I remember liking it. I think I could have been watching it on cable, and I think I turned it or
but
something.
I didn't
really get into it. And I'm a huge, let me just say something, I'm a huge Robin Williams fan. And I still think some of his better movies, I still like Patch Adams.
Favorites.
Patch Adams
yes.
is an excellent movie, and I also think, I kind of like the Bicentennial Man. I don't really remember that.
Yeah.
There was Jack. You know, that's the one where he ages.
Right.
He does like 7-8 years per year of a human year.
It's crazy.
Or something. Or
it's
almost like dog years, isn't it?
Yep.
Or more. I can't remember. Maybe it was like 14 years.
Then you got Mrs. Doubtfire, which I loved.
No, you got The World According to Gar.
Oh, I haven't seen that
one. That was another one. That was the one with John Lithgow.
Right.
Glenn Close.
Haven't seen it.
Close.
Yeah.
That's a good one as well. I don't know if you can get those in blue.
I don't know.
But those are some of the better ones.
Yeah.
So.
All right. So, of course, you know, today was the new release day. So, this is the first time it's came to 4K. This is the 30th anniversary edition. And that is Total Recall. I'm so excited to watch this one. I love the art on this one, guys. So freaking amazing. I like this art better than the Steelbook, in my opinion. It's got that really nice gloss, or like different colors when you turn it around. But like I said, this is the 30th anniversary edition. But
Do I have that one in blue?
Blu-ray, yes.
But do I have it?
Yes.
It'd be interesting to put the blue in there and compare it to the 4K.
Well, the Blu-ray's in here too, so.
Well, don't you find? I want to say something real quick. Don't you find it kind of amusing or ironic that every time somebody watches one of these new movies in 4K, we have to.
Yeah.
They basically say the same thing. It's the best that's ever looked, best that's ever seen. They've seen. Do you necessarily agree with that?
I hear it all the time. So.
Yeah, I do too.
But I'm so excited to watch it. I've never seen this all the way through, so so excited to add this to the collection. And it was $14.99 at Best Buy, so so awesome. So it was Total Recall, guys.
This floor is cold.
All right, so this one came out today. I forgot this was coming out today. I've never seen this movie, but I've heard really good things about it, and that is Collateral with Tom Cruise and Jamie Foxx. So so excited to see this one. I'll be watching this one real soon, guys. Came out in 2004. I've wanted to see this movie for a long time, but never have, so I cannot wait to see it. But
so why did you buy that in blue instead of 4K?
They only had two copies of this one at my Best Buy, so so excited to see this, guys. You want to watch it with me?
No.
Yes. So excited, guys. Okay. All right, so the next two, I'm so excited to get these. They didn't have the third one. They had the new one there, that Michael Corleone one or something, but...
it's not Michael Corleone.
It is.
It's what's it called? Pizzur or something?
But it's Cologne. I'm just saying Cologne. But it's based off Michael Corleone or something like
Michael
that.
Michael Corleone.
I saw the third one on Amazon for $10. I need to pick that one up. But I picked up Godfather 1 and 2. So,
why did you just
these.
Pick up the trilogy?
I like the slipcovers on these. Look at that, gorgeous, guys.
Oh.
But they didn't have the third one there, which I don't understand why they do that. You have two, but not the other one. I don't get it. But these are $8.99 a piece. So excited to see. These are long freaking movies, guys.
I thought you said the third one. You saw it. Did you see it online?
Yeah,
it
Amazon,
was for
$10.99. Yeah, so
a dollar more.
Gorgeous slips on these,
is that
guys.
Prime?
I think so, yeah. But gorgeous, gorgeous slipcovers. This is embossed right here. But I'm so excited to see these. I've seen like bits and pieces of these films. He has a whole collection of these. But
bits and pieces?
Yeah, like on TV when it comes on. But
would it be called Chapters?
Yes, but this is the 45th anniversary edition. So, yeah, so glad to add these to the collection. Finally, guys. So there's those two. All right, so the final one.
I don't think you'll ever watch
yes,
those.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Yes, I will.
Why don't you just open my setup that I bought? I just bought a set, the trilogy.
Why?
Well, that's what it's for.
I know, but anyway.
You can open it up. You can watch it. Why do you look at me like that? It kind of bothers me.
All right, so the final one, guys. This came out, I think, last year. And I've been wanting to pick it up. I was always waiting for it to come down because I didn't want to pay, like, it was like $19 new or something. So I was waiting for it to come down. It was eventually Walmart put these on sale for $5. I could never find it with a slipcover. So we're at Walmart today. I saw like four or five copies with a slip. I picked it up, guys. And that is a movie called Jexy with Adam Devine, Michael Pena. Cannot wait to see this one. I've been wanting to see it since last year. And so excited to add this to the collection. So yeah, there's that one. All right, guys, so those are all our pickups for today. And you want to show them?
Yeah.
Show them? Okay.
And,
all right, so don't tell me yet.
No, I'm not.
Okay.
Something we had mentioned a couple of videos ago, we were talking, or I was talking about going through my collection and, you know, whatever copies that I have that were extra, because I do have some that are double or triple, like I mentioned before, and what I was going to do was give those to Kimberly. And then what she could do, she could give them away to her subscribers. So because I haven't gotten to that yet, so what I decided to do today in the store, now I don't know, you may or may not like these, but what we're going to do is we're going to give these away. And the way we're going to do it is hopefully if you already have these movies, I'm not sure how we're going to be able to get around that. Well, But what we decided to do, here's what we decided to do was to make it fair, is we were going to just see how many subscribers we get.
Comments.
I'm sorry about that. See how many comments we get today. And then what we'll do, we'll randomly take a piece of paper, cut out however many that is. And then what we'll do, we'll put them in something and we'll randomly draw it from it.
Yep.
And we figured that'd be the best way to do it. That way one person doesn't get both.
Right, exactly.
So anyway, that's kind of what we were leaning, or what we are going to do.
If you already have these movies, guys, please don't enter the giveaway, okay?
Yeah, that's what I should have said. I should have said that because...
This is for people that do not have these movies, okay? If you already have them, please don't enter the giveaway. We're just trying to, you know, do something for the holidays where he came up with this idea himself because he's so freaking amazing. But I have something for you guys as well. Oh, hold on. All right, guys, what were we talking about? But he's going to give away those...
Oh, that's small,
Kimber. Stop, you.
I just caught up.
Okay.
Quit.
He's going to give those movies away, okay? But I'm going to do something for you guys as well, because I haven't done a code giveaway in a long time. So one winner is going to win every single one of these codes right here, guys. So that's like, how many movies is that? Six? Six movies, so six codes right here for you guys. So we're going to give this contest 3 days. I'm going to do a giveaway for mine and giveaway for his. So... later on, we'll unbox every single one of these movies later on. And there'll be two videos today, guys.
Well, let me show the movies.
Okay, go ahead.
Let me show
so
the
his
movies.
Movies are those. Okay.
Yeah, and like I said, I thought, you know, I thought these were pretty good movies. At least I did growing up. So somebody may not appreciate.
Here,
and
I
this,
got it.
You'll let you do that.
Bogus Journey 1 and 2, the Screen Factory double feature right here. And then this came out a couple weeks ago, and that is the... trilogy of the Rob Zombie trilogy, House of a Thousand Corpses, The Devil's Rejects, and Three from Hell. So one winner will win this one, and one winner will win this one. So I said, just if you do already have these movies, guys, please do not enter the giveaway. We want someone that does not have these movies to win them. So
like I mentioned earlier, I probably didn't get it out. I don't know if I got it out or not. I just did this primarily because, actually for two reasons. And one reason was because I haven't had a chance to go through my collection to see what I have, extra, double, whatever.
Right.
And then secondly, I just thought because with Christmas coming up, I thought it'd be a good thing to do.
Yep.
So that's
so
pretty much it. I actually thought about that today in the store. So
hopefully
somebody will appreciate it.
So Friday, this is those. From Screen Shout Factory. I'm sorry, guys, but
I'm gonna get up.
All right. So Friday we'll do a giveaway or the. The contest ends on Friday, guys. So, and mine as well. So we're going to do one video, for the giveaway. Okay. For the winners. So like I said, one hat would be for his and then one hat would be for mine. Okay. Cause like I said later, I'm unboxing all those movies for you guys.
Oh, real quick, Kimberly, forget them. I know. Hopefully they don't have an issue with me cutting up. Like
no,
nope,
you're good.
I don't take, I try to take life, you know, hey, one day at a time. And try to make the most of it in a sense.
Yep.
But one thing to mention real quick is I still haven't gotten my Beastmaster yet.
From Vinegar Syndrome.
Syndrome. So hopefully they're going to be sending out in the next.
Your Tremors 4K.
Send out.
Tremors 4K set should be here as well, too.
Sent out.
So from Arrow.
Which one?
So excited. The Tremors 4K from Arrow, that thick box set.
Oh, and by the way.
Gorgeous.
And by the way, wasn't that a birthday gift?
It was a birthday gift.
Yeah, it
yes.
was a birthday gift. And so, is there anything else that I got coming?
Nope. Well, next year, next year, I pre-ordered him the An American Werewolf in London, still from Zombies. So that should be here in March of next year.
Did you
so
tell
excited.
Them? I'm sorry. I hate to keep interrupting, but you forget so much. Did you tell them there's 1,500? And there's one with a poster, isn't it?
But he won't let me click on it.
And then each time we click on it, it goes back
to the main
page.
So I don't get it. But anyway, guys, so those are all the pickups for this week, guys. And so later on, I'll go in my room and unbox those movies. And so I'll pick one winner for all those codes, guys. So that'll be my Christmas present for you guys, to one of you guys. And some awesome movies there, guys. I'm so excited for you to win those. And of course, his as well. So. Anyway, that's just pretty much it. So make sure to like this video, comment down below. Let me know what did you pick up today, and I guess I will talk to you later. Bye.
Oh, we should have-